Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we're going to talk about meth injection versus port injection, what that really means, and how you can use meth safely. So this is kind of a follow-up video to the one that was discussing whether you should upgrade a high-pressure fuel pump or port injection. I mentioned in that video that if you're only going to be running 93 octane and trying to make big power, you're not really going to run into a big fuel flow issue. The problem that you're going to run into is needing octane. So the question a lot of people ask is, can they use meth, and is meth even safe? Because they keep seeing these cars run into issues when they run meth injection. So they think port injection is safer, or a high pressure fuel pump upgrade is safer. So I'm going to kind of explain that to you guys now. Now, first things first, if you're comparing port injection to meth injection, you should understand that you're not really comparing two different things. Port injection refers to where your auxiliary fuel system is injecting the fuel. So you have two options. You can either do it right at the port and inject at six separate points that go directly into the cylinder head, or you can inject somewhere else like your throttle body, your charge pipe. Sometimes you can even inject before the turbo in certain scenarios. So port injection is where you're spraying. Now meth injection is what you're spraying. So when you're running methanol, you can spray that anywhere you want. There is not a difference between port injection and meth injection. Meth is what you're spraying, port is where you're spraying it. So the issue that a lot of people see with meth injection is it's typically injected at one point. So let's say you're injecting it right here on the charge pipe or somewhere around here, like in a throttle body spacer. That one injection point is going to need to spray enough fuel to get it distributed to all six of the cylinders. So it gets sucked into the throttle body, gets into the intake manifold, and whatever valve opens up will suck in the air fuel mix right before the injectors begin to actually spray, you know, fuel from your fuel tank. So the benefit of meth is adding that into your mix provides a significant increase in octane. It's just like adding ethanol into your fuel. So that way you can get a mix of your pump gas with some high octane methanol, and that will increase the limits of how much timing you can run, how much boost you can run, and it also adds a cooling effect. Now the main downside is when you're injecting at one point, you're not going to get an even distribution across all the cylinders. And typically what happens is cylinders 5 and 6 get the least amount of fuel. So you're potentially going to lean out those cylinders if you don't have an appropriate tune for your meth injection system. So what happens is across all 6 cylinders, you're injecting fuel, you're sucking in various amounts of meth, and then it comes out the exhaust and goes through one O2 sensor that's measuring your AFRs. And what the car is doing is taking that one point of measurement across all 6 cylinders and adjusting how much fuel to inject. So if you're injecting your meth at one point and getting an uneven distribution of meth across the cylinders, that one measurement downstream is not going to give the car enough information to safely adjust the AFRs across all the cylinders. So that's why some people run into issues. You can basically lean out the cylinders that are farther away from the injection point, and that can cause excess heat, that can cause piston cracking, ringlets failing, things like that. Now, there is a pretty safe way to run this, even though it's not really recommended. Typically, what you want to do is tune for your meth, and that includes running a richer target AFR at your O2 sensor to compensate, so that way the meth that's making it to your, you know, farther away cylinders is still rich enough that you're not going to lean out those cylinders. So if you're typically targeting, you know, 12.7 or 12.8 AFR when you're just DI only, if you're adding meth injection at the charge pipe, you might want to richen it up to like 12.2 or something that will help compensate for the uneven distribution. Now, personally, I feel like the reason why this is a bigger issue on our cars is because of the throttle body location. If you look at older N-series like N54 and N55 engines, or even the S55, the throttle body's in the middle. So you don't have as big of an issue because cylinders 3 and 4 get the most fuel, cylinders 1 and 6 get the least fuel, but you don't have a cylinder that's as far from the throttle body as you do on the B58, because we're basically all the way down here injecting fuel, and that has to make it all the way across all 6 cylinders to the very last one. So that's why it's not as big of an issue on the N54 and N55. and maybe a lot of you coming from other platforms had good luck with it, so you thought it would work the same here. And you just need to take an extra step to make sure it's going to run safe on your car. Usually when I see people having issues, they either didn't tune for it or they're just adding meth injection with an OTS map that doesn't compensate for the additional fuel coming in. Now this issue also applies if you're injecting fuel, and a lot of people don't even remember this anymore, but about 2 years ago, a fuel injection system came in for the charge pipe, and that is going to have the exact same limitations as meth injection. So again, there's not a difference between port injection and meth, it's just what fuel you want to spray and where you want to spray it. So since injecting at the throttle body or one point of injection at the charge pipe can be such a concern, the solution is to move to port injection. And what that'll do is allow you to spray right at the cylinder head. You can get an even distribution of meth across all six cylinders, and you'll have a lot more flow because you'll have six nozzles instead of one or two. So that's really the best and safest option. The downside is it's a lot more complicated to install, and you also will need to have a high quality controller to make sure it can control, you know, the fuel distribution across all six of the nozzles. So that's typically what I recommend if you only have 93 octane available. That's the best way to get your octane up and add additional fuel. Like I said, a small fuel pump plus port injected meth will give you a lot of headroom. You'll basically be running just like the guys running fully 85 and things like that, and you can support a lot of power. The other nice thing about it is you can inject whatever fuel you want. So let's say that you have E85 available, but you don't want to run it all the time. You can put E85 in your meth injection system and set it up to spray just like a meth injection system would. So you can set it up to start spraying at 10 PSI and come to full spray at 20 PSI or whatever the case may be. And while you're just driving around town, you're only running on 93 octane. So that's a real nice way for people that maybe don't have E85, you know, a couple miles down the road, and you don't want to have to drive across town to get it all the time, or you don't want to feel like you're just wasting the E85 in the tank when you're cruising to work and things like that. You can add a meth injection system and put meth, E85, race gas, whatever you want in there, and set it up to only spray when you're in boost, so it's only being used when you're actually racing or pushing the car. So that's a really nice option to have. So hopefully this video helps you guys out. You know, those of you that only have 93 octane available, or you don't want to worry about mixing E85 or driving across town to find an E85 pump, port injection meth is a great option so that you can increase your octane so that you can safely turn up your horsepower. So hopefully this video helps. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Thanks.